Next, we have rules of thumb, or say thumb rule for tonnage. Okay, but before this, what is thumb rule? Thumb rule is what, based on the previous experience, if you are just taking the decision roughly, that we can call as a thumb rule, right? So you see, a thumb rule in engineering is a general guideline or a rough estimate that can be quickly used for initial calculation. Thumb rule is for initial calculation, not for the final decision. And in HVC, we are using this thumb rule at the initial stage, or for small project directly based on the thumb rule, we'll consider that equipment selection also. Small project means I'm talking about a small villa. I'm talking about India, not in Gulf or Asian countries. Even for a small villa, they will do the detailed calculation. But in India, we don't require that much. Means as per that conditions and the economical condition and the weather condition, mostly in India, they're using thumb rule directly for small projects. Again, in India, for a big project for highest building, the complete calculation is required. Or at the initial stage of a big project, one can use this thumb rule. So based on the thumb rule, we have this values and can be asked in interview. You need to memorize this. You see, 1 ton, you know what is ton, TR, will cover 100 square feet. Square feet of what? Area. And I'm considering 3 meter as a standard height of the space. 3 meter, 10 feet. Okay. So 1 ton will cover for 100 square feet. And this is outdated. This is for or based on the old school. And you see, I've given this point. Common construction without insulation. This we used almost 7 years or 10 years back. But 9 market, 1 TR equal to 100 square feet means it's a very, very low efficient system. And now in market, we are talking about the saving of energy, green building, value engineering, sustainability, etc. So this is just for information. In actual practice, we have some values, which is below, we'll discuss. But still, this is in common practice, especially for a small project in India. So 1 TR will cover 100 square feet area with the standard 10 feet height, 3 meter, for expose more than 2. For example, consider is a room, top view. This is a room. This side is exposed, this side is exposed, and this side is also exposed. Only this side, we have one more room. In that case, we required this for 100 square feet area, 1 ton is required. If the room is, say, 200 square feet, we can consider, say, 2 TR, just roughly. Similarly, if the room is not completely exposed, you see, for room exposed, one or less. So only one side exposed, remaining we have this other room, this side also other rooms. In that case, we can consider 110 up to 130 square feet of area. Again, this is just outdated. Now, in actual practice, we have this 1 TR equal to, 1 TR will cover 400 to 600 square feet. I'm talking about the standard insulated building, or I can say green building or the standard project. Now, if you talk about standard or a high class project, you'll find the insulation in the wall, in the roof, and even for a small project, even India, in roof, you'll find the insulation. You may not find in the wall, but you will find in the roof. And roof means what? Which is exposed to sun, the top slab. So remember, if you talk about the green building or for standard insulated building, we can consider 400 to 600 square feet for 1 ton. Very efficient. This is just a rough estimate.
But in insulation means...
Insulation means, which is, you see, insulation or a conductor, reverse of a conductor. A copper is a good conductor, and for example, polyurethane or... say thermocol, general thermocol, you know, no? EPS, extended polystyrene, technically is a good insulation, which is used to reduce the heat transfer. No? Insulation is the reverse of a conductor. You know this, conductor or insulator, as a mechanical, even electrical people also relate this one. Suppose, for example, in at the time of constructing the wall, suppose this is a brick and cement plaster. Now, after that, I'm using a plywood, a 1-inch plywood inside. Or before this, I'm using insulation like EPS or polyurethane or fiberglass, etc. So what will happen? The heat transfer from outside to inside is going to be less, na, compared with the without insulation. But don't worry, we have a separate topic in detail about this insulation at the time of load calculation. Before starting the load calculation, at the time of preparing input file, we'll discuss how to find this UNR. And UNR is depend on the type of material. Okay, so and we'll talk about the importance of insulation. This is very, very important for HVC point of view and even for green building concept. Okay, so at this level, just memorize this thumb rules. May ask in interview. And I've given one example also from this rules of thumb handbook. You see, at the initial stage, one can use this rules of thumb handbook, and I have just pick one page which is belongs to office. You see, for office, general office, 300 to 400 square feet per turn. Similarly, for interior space and Yeah, for large areas, 225 to 275, because in that equipments are less. Similarly, large interior, 300 to 350, like this. This is just example. Like this in the rules of thumb handbook, we'll use at the time of designing also, just for reference point if you're at the initial stage. In that, you'll find the rules of thumb for different application. Just I pick for office with the 6.01 section. Similarly, you'll find the rules of thumb for hotels, you'll find for school, etc. I'll share you that, don't worry, at the time of calculation. This is just an example.